the Wildcat.
Thousand Islands and Seaway Cruises, your captain and crew, welcome aboard the Wildcat. Today we'll be flying at an altitude of 0 feet, offering a spectacular view of Thousand Islands, made with bold and scenic houses, and much, much more. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the comforting breezes of the windy St. Lawrence River as we embark on our Castle Prowler adrenaline cruise. Just a quick note about shipboard safety aboard the Wildcat. Operation of the vessel and certification of the crew is governed by Transport Canada, and the boat is fully equipped with safety equipment in accordance with marine safety regulations. There are life jackets on board for a full complement of passengers and crew, with adult life jackets stowed in the forward deck compartment, and children's life jackets accessible through the doors and the sides of the forward stairs and the front of the bridge or wheels. You will be advised whether it is safe to stand for photography, to stretch your legs, or to access the washrooms located behind the bridge. Snack and licensed beverage service will also be available at your seats during low-speed segments of the tour. While the cruise is not designed as a get-wet experience, you may encounter waves from the prevailing winds or the wakes of passing ships, so please be prepared for that possibility. Lastly, we will be traveling at speeds of up to 70 kilometers per hour, so we must insist that all passengers remain seated during high-speed runs. As you can plainly see now, we've slowed the vessel, so at this time we invite you to feel free to stand for photography or just to stretch out a little bit.
Alexandria Bay.
We'll be coming around again with our lights.
Yeah.
ahead of us now over the bow is famous Gold Castle on Hart Island. Built by George Bull, the castle stands as a testament to the American dream. Born in Germany on the Isle of Rügen in the Baltic Sea, a young George immigrated to the United States in the mid-1800s, where he landed his first job as a busboy in a New York City hotel. Through hard work in industry, he rose through the ranks to become the proprietor of the Waldorf Astoria in New York, and he built the Bellevue Stratford in Philadelphia. In 1899, at the pinnacle of his career, Bull started construction on the castle as a Valentine's present for his wife Louise. It was nearing completion in 1904 when word came of Louise's untimely death at the age of only 42. Over 300 stonemasons and laborers dropped their tools, and construction on the castle was halted. While George did return to the Thousand Islands, he never again stepped foot on Hart Island in memory of his beloved wife. For 75 years, the castle stood unfinished until 1978, when the castle was taken over by the Thousand Islands Bridge Authority, who have opened it to the public and have been aggressively restoring the castle to its original splendor. There are, however, no plans to complete the castle. In fact, the revenue generated by over 100,000 visitors each year is barely enough to pay for the castle maintenance and restoration. In the distance off our right side, we can see the Bull Yacht House, where Bull maintained his fleet of over 13 boats. The boathouse itself is a grand structure, and unlike the castle, is on the American list of historic places for being the largest building constructed completely of cedar, shake, and shingle. This massive structure could accommodate vessels of up to 38 meters in length, with the tallest of doors reaching for masts of 20 meters in height. Today, the Yacht House 2 is open to the public, housing a collection of boats and other antique boats. The Bull Yacht House is situated on Wellesley Island, the largest of the American islands, accessible from the Thousand Islands International Bridge. George Bull owned a large portion of the island where he operated two large farms that supplied meat and produce for his hotels and where he established the Golf and Country Club back in 1890. The Thousand Islands Club, as it is still known today, touted a very exclusive list of members, paying $100,000 to join with an annual membership fee of $10,000. A lot of money today, let alone back in 1895. As we come along the west end of Hart Island, we can see the stone seawall erected to complete the shape of the island into a Valentine's heart. And let it not be said that George Bull was not a generous man. The quaint little brown cottage coming up on the right with the appropriate name of Nothing Left Over was what George had built for his mother-in-law, who was rumored to be a great swimmer. At the head of the island to our left, we can see the Arch of Hearts, modeled after the Arc de Triomphe in Paris, France. Guests arriving at the castle would have been ferried under the arch to the docks in the inner harbor to be greeted by George and Louise. Continuing along on our left is a unique structure known as the Ulster Tower, intended as a playhouse for George Bull's two children, a son and a daughter. Built completely without plans, the tower features a library, a ballroom, theater, billiard room, and a two-lane bowling alley in the basement.
As the family giant would say, if you look up, look way up, there's Rusty and Jerome. Oh, there's a deer up there silhouetted between the two peaks of the castle. That's a hart, H-A-R-T. A species of deer indigenous to the forests of Germany where young George grew up. And another interesting way that he's incorporated hearts into his Valentine themed castle.
To our left now at the foot of Hart Island is a pompous clock tower designed to supply power, hot and cold running water, and steam heat to the six-story, 120-room castle in adjoining buildings. During a 1938 4th of July fireworks celebration, a strange skyrocket went around the roof and started a fire that completely gutted the complex. Its restoration is a great example of the fine work being carried out by the Thousand Islands Bridge Authority.
by the Atlas 20 and 2nd Pathfinders.